He's attacking every day, but I'm watching while I pray. No matter the attack, I won't turn back. I'm going to dig in and say this means war.
All right. And that is a great song, and it's still playing everywhere. I mean, that's like it quickly became a classic. Who are some of your influences in gospel?
You know what? I got influences all across the board. There's so many beautiful people. At the top of my list is a guy named Kirk Franklin, who, you know, I go back to the Why We Sing days. He's been inspiring me. Mary is one of my favorites. And, you know, I gotta reach outside the genre. Otis Redding is a huge inspiration. Mm-hmm. Aretha Franklin, Stevie Wonder, and Ray Charles, James Brown, Michael Jackson, of course. So it's in the genre and outside of the genre.
Mm-hmm. Okay, that sounds great. So what's coming up next? You got a new album coming out any day?
I got a brand new single that should be coming your way soon. If you don't have it, it's called Can't Turn Back. It's old church meets Cab Calloway, the Nicholas Brothers, a little Ray Charles, it's big band, big horns, meets stomp a hole in the floor, clap your hands. It's kind of one of the number one sales guy in the gospel music industry. He said it's the second coming of war. I don't know, but it's a feel good Sunday morning church vibe with a little fresh take on it. And I got a new album coming this summer called Keep the Faith. With lots of fun features. I got the old school legends, Dottie Peoples, Shirley Caesar. I got a couple greats. The producer, Teddy Riley, is on a track. Stephanie Mills is on a track. And it's all sing-along music. I'll be touring the country starting this summer after the Festival of Praise. And I'm excited. It's going to be insane.
Okay. That sounds great. And I hope you do come through here with that one. How did you get involved with Festival of Praise?
You know what? It's a funny story. Fred Hammond's brother Ray told me that during the last Festival of Praise a couple years ago, they were, before the show, they were playing my song, This Means War. And when it came on, he said everybody in the audience stood up and started clapping. The DJ was playing it. Everybody was singing it full voice. And then he said that they tried to end the song because Fred said it's time to start the show. And Ray said, I can't stop it. People are going to kill me. So they stopped the music, and people kept singing to the top of their lungs and clapping. And it did not stop. They had to wait until people stopped to start the show. And they had a meeting and said, if this is what happens when the DJ plays it, we got to have him on the tour. So that's how I got on the tour. And it's been insane every single night, every single city.
Oh, any final words? What advice? I always ask gospel artists this. What advice can you give them for starting out a career in gospel music?
It all starts with the song. A lot of times, and some artists can do this theory where they start from their own creativity and they give people what they think they should have. But I think it's important to ask God, what do you want the people to have, and have a focus on creating content that will bring the people to what you have to offer versus you forcing something on them. And my approach is to make what's going to serve the masses. I call it crowd music. And so first it starts with the song, and then you got to be willing to invest in yourself. The masses will come to you if you're willing to throw everything at yourself. I got a second job to invest in my first album, in my first project. And I work nights, and so you got to be willing to go the extra mile to invest in you. And then you gotta market. You gotta work hard. It looks easy, but the grind is insane. And God will bless your works. Faith without works is dead. But God, you gotta give God something to bless.
Oh, that's some good advice right there. All right. I thank you so much, Pastor Charles Jenkins, for being on the show today. And everybody across the country is looking forward. Okay. Thank you, sir.
Much love.
There were many that started out with me, but now they've gone astray. Ooh, but I'm still holding on.
That song just takes me in every time I hear it, because it's just like very encouraging. No matter what you're going through, how far you have fallen down, even, you know, when it comes down to your family, your friends, you can always rely on God and remember to just keep holding on, keep hope alive, keep your faith. Don't give your faith away. Don't give it away to the enemy. You know, stand strong. You know, trials and tribulations come to make us strong. Be encouraged in the Lord this morning, wherever you're listening at, wherever you're listening from. Just be encouraged. Speaking of that, y'all, did y'all hear that interview while ago with Pastor Charles Jenkins and Nina Taylor of the Gospel News? It was awesome. Artists, if you're listening out there, he gave some very valuable information toward the end of that interview. You know, just throw yourself out there and and invest in yourself. That's what you can do. You can invest in yourself. And, you know, you can gain a lot just by investing in your prayer life. In your prayer life, you can gain a lot just by asking God, what is it, Lord, that you want me to give your people? That was awesome. That was so cool. That was cool. Way to go, Nina Taylor, for that interview. Y'all, so it's time for the Relationship 411. I'm a little bit late on it, but hey, it is what it is. Okay, so Relationship 411 is talking about church and mental illness. You know, that's something we don't hear a lot about in the churches is mental illness. We hear everything else called out, from high blood pressure and diabetes. But we don't hear a lot about mental illness. Y'all got to excuse me. I am moving in this chair. Okay? So mental illness can affect anyone, first of all. And we do know. We already know that that is a trick of the enemy. We already know that Satan comes to steal, kill, and destroy. We already know that these imaginations, hallucinations, and delusional influences will be out there. But what people don't need to know, but what people don't know is that God allows these psychiatrists and stuff. He gives them wisdom to help us. The same way you would get up and take your blood pressure medication every day, you need to have a relationship with a psychiatrist as well if you're dealing with any type of mental illness. Yes, God will heal you and completely heal you, as he done me. He has healed me over and over and over again. It's not a one-time battle. You're going to always be facing the temptation to fall into the trap of these illusions. Remember, Jesus was in that wilderness 40 days and 40 nights. And during that time, he wasn't eating. And so the devil saw opportunity to step in and try to lure him to his side. And that's how it is with us church folk. We got to realize that if the devil tried to tempt Jesus, then he's going to try to tempt us too. And therefore, we need to always be willing to go get help. Mental illness is real. It's real. It's not a joke. It's out here. People believe what they believe. And, you know, things can happen, good or bad. In my case, I went through a battle of it. I've actually battled with it all of my life. But I always bounce back and I always go right back to my faith. Even whenever I'm depressed a little bit. Look, these things come. Even Paul had a thorn in his side that was just bugging him. The whole time that was just painful. Things in life are going to happen that are just painful to us, and we need to get help. And sometimes the only way we can get the help that we really need is to step outside of our comfort zone. I don't understand why people have make such a big deal about going to see a psychiatrist when all this person is doing is listening at you talk. First of all, they're listening at you talk. You give them your side of things. Otherwise, you might not can give your side of things at your home or to a family member or people who really know you deeply. So whenever you get the opportunity to go to a psychiatrist and talk to them, you know, you're talking to a complete stranger. And you wouldn't believe the healing that is just in speaking, because some of these psychiatrists teach you how to speak over your life and to speak positive and how not to take in all the negativity. Negativity is always going to be in our lives. It is. But you do not.